Let's see if we can understand a thing or two about futures curves. And I've drawn two futures curves here. And really all they show is the different settlement prices for the different delivery dates of futures. So let's say that this orange curve is one of them. What this says is, if for delivery today, we wanted to buy or sell an apple, the market rate is 10 cents a pound. So this isn't a futures contract at all. This is actually called the spot price. It's essentially the market price for that commodity or that security today. We're just using the example of apple. So this tells us at time zero, you can buy or sell an apple based on the current market for 10 cents. Now, when we move to one, the way I've labeled this axis, it says 1 month from now. This is not saying that the market price is going to go up 1 month from now. This is saying that today, if you were to go into the futures market and say, I want to sell or I want to buy apples 1 month from now, what type of a settlement price can I get on my futures contract? And based on this futures curve, it looks like we could do about 12 cents. I'm going to repeat what I just said. This is not saying that a month from now that the market price, that the spot price is going to move up. Only this time zero is the spot price. What this is saying is right now, the market is saying if you want to enter into a futures contract for delivery a month from now, that delivery price will be 12 cents. If you want to deliver 2 months from now, that delivery price might be around 15 cents. If you want to deliver 8 months from now, that delivery price might be something like 20 cents. If you wanted to show movement, let's say all of a sudden people just get more bullish on apples or there's some new diet that tells everyone that apples help you lose weight, what you would probably see is this entire curve would shift up. So regardless of delivery date, you would probably see this entire curve shift up because people would want apples across the entire futures curve. And this one that we're highlighting right now, I've drawn two futures curves. I've drawn an upward sloping orange one, and I've also drawn a downward sloping blue one, and I'll focus on that one in the next video. But this upward sloping is kind of a normal curve, and it's actually called that. It's a normal curve because this is what you actually expect for most types of commodities. And you can imagine why. If this wasn't upward sloping, there would actually be no reason for you to hold on to something, especially if this was downward sloping. You'd be like, wow, if for future delivery dates I'm getting lower and lower prices, why don't I just sell now? And that would actually create downward pressure on the current spot price. And you could, of course, make the arbitrage arguments I made in previous videos, why you shouldn't, in a theoretical setting, see a downward sloping futures curve. What we're going to talk a little bit about in the next video is maybe why you would see a downward sloping futures curve, where the delivery price for delivery further out than the spot price, or for further out months than nearby months, is actually lower. And just to give you a little terminology, this type of curve right here is called an inverted curve. And I'll talk in the next video on why you might see one of those.